हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर जहूर, एक्सडीन फैकल्टी ऑफ फाइन आर्ट, जामिया मिलिया इस्लामिया यूनिवर्सिटी, न्यू दिल्ली. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डू अ डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन ऑन हाउ टू यूज ऑयल पेंट्स फॉर पेंटिंग अ लैंडस्केप. स्पीकिंग ऑफ अ लैंडस्केप पिक्चर, वन प्री सपोजेज दैट द पिक्चर कंटेन्स विद इन इट्स बाउंड्रीज अ फोरग्राउंड. हेयर आई एम यूजिंग स्टूडेंट ऑयल कलर्स. In oil sketching, it is nearly always best to paint low in tone with thin color, using plenty of oil medium such as linseed oil and turpentine oil, and finally place the solid lighter colors over the darker tints. Here I am using thin colors. I have taken burnt sienna and a little bit of yellow ochre to just fill up the place. I am not using a broad brush, but instead I am using a number 9 or number 10 brush. It will be a beautiful filling. I have used more of turpentine and very less of linseed oil. I just mix it up and spread this color all over. Try to handle your brush from the back side. It will give more flexibility and move your hands from the elbow. This is the season of oil colors, not acrylic colors. During hot summer season, when there is too much of heat, oil paints are very good for that season. Usually they dry slowly. But due to oxidation during summer, they dry very fast. Here I am using a thin coat of burnt sienna and mixing yellow ochre in it. So I have one formula here which I have already discussed with you, that is about the basic composition, the masses. So I will have a strong mass at my right side and a small mass here at the left side. In this way I will divide the space. I will make the top area a little bit lighter and the bottom area will be more darker. Because of the gravitational force, all the bottom area looks heavy, so it is more darker here. This is just a sketch and something will come out of this. So let's develop these sketches here. Feel your landscape first. Keep your hand moving restlessly, thinking all the while about what the subject is like, what is happening, and letting it come out on the paper freely and instinctively. You are not making a factual drawing or a map. You are seeking essential forms and movements. See, I can do anything like this and lift out some color from here. You can use rug or anything you like. I am using here burnt sienna. Maybe I can use green. I will try to make monochromatic color scheme here. Here you have to keep in mind the perspective. It is taken for granted that the student of landscape art has some knowledge of elementary perspective. If not, some lessons in perspective are advisable, particularly that section relating to buildings and reflections on water. So out of this I have got a sketch also, which is comprised of the sky area, the ground, the foreground, and the middle area, a small soft of hut here, and the foliage here. These are very simple items in a simple painting. I am making this a little bit darker. So I am using a dark color here. Just see the position of the brush and how I am using it. Make this part a little darker here. There will be a reflection here in the border. So I am making it darker also. Here I want to divide the canvas into two parts. Just lift a little area from here. Little area from there with more movement. Try to make things like this and create different textures. You will enjoy them. See how this dark color is looking here. It is reflecting complete balance. Using hog hair brush to get the color penetrated inside the pores. A variety of brushes can be used to achieve different results. It also depends on your practice. The more experience you have, you will know what each brush can do for you. Try to work as a master used to work. It is simple. Simple strokes, but confident strokes. It takes a lot of hard work. You should work at least for 8 hours a day. Only then you will have control over the brush and color, and they will follow your gestures. Almost any mark or brush stroke an artist puts down is, in a sense, the result of a gesture. I have got something automatically here and I am developing those things. I have nothing in mind that I will make a particular thing here. I don't plan things. Go directly on the canvas and start painting, but keep in mind one thing. The division of space. That is very important. I have taken this line as a horizon line here and lot of sky there. I have divided this space into two parts broadly. For further division, it can be divided into two more parts, making it four in all. Previously, I have made a hut. But now I am just trying to make a tree. Just put bits of dark color. I will create perspective through lines and colors. Remember, always a warm color takes front and foreground. Middle colors are greens, they take middle, and the cools, the blues, they take the background. Think of these things in the beginning, because these three colors take three different steps: foreground, middle, and the background. I am using more dark colors and more strokes here in the foreground to give a strong base. You can lift some colors if you want to achieve that right effect. color blocking is a very important aspect of painting. How to block the composition? To see what is essential and formed as basis to get the basic form of a painting can be achieved through color blocking. Through the variations of tones and shades, perspective can be created with the use of less color also. The viewer's eye enters the picture at the lower edge and travels along the main lines to the focal point of the painting, because artist has to guide the eye of the viewer. Unless and until he guides, they will stuck at one place. I have to take a person inside my painting, so he will walk through and move to the focal point here. From here, I will take him around and again he can get back to this place. It is the artist's job, so he should know how to travel the eye. Add some color. You can take a dry brush and you can wet it to create perspective line. Take little strokes. For this purpose, I used a soft brush. So it will hold color. Hog ear brush will spread it. That was for the beginning. Now I am using little delicate strokes. With a hog hair brush, you can lift or add any color. It is up to the practice. Add one color that will give it a little bit more darker shade. What is that color which can be used here? A soft color, and that can go well with this. Don't use black. You may be surprised to know that you don't require the black color to get a darker shade. Once you begin to experiment with color mixing, you will find that you don't really need black. You can mix much more interesting dark, containing a fascinating hint of color. By blending such colors as blue and brown, red and green, orange and blue, and blue-brown mixture makes far more interesting grays than you can create with black. This is burnt sienna, which is a bright orange brown that produce a very different range of blue grays and brown grays when mixed with the blues, plus rich coppery tones when blended with reds and yellows. You can use some sap green here to give that dark shade. Sap green is a cool color and burnt sienna is a warm color. When we mix these two colors, the color becomes darker. By adding a complementary color, you can make any color darker. So I am using the complementary color green with the reddish burnt sienna to get a dark tone. According to the perspective, the foreground is the nearest part of the painting. Therefore, much more detailing and darker strokes can be used in it. Moving on to middle portion. Where all the lights is. I am adding some light color. Then the background will be worked on. Just try to take out some more color from the sky using a dry brush. Just keep this area lighter. For the beginners, such type of work is very important. How to take out light colors and then mix it up, and it will be a beautiful cloud here. Use some turpentine oil and lift some color. Again, mix them and it will look like a cloud. You should respond as directly as possible drawing, not a cloud, but the movement of bulk of a cloud, drawing not a branch, but the way it grows. Reaches out and moves in space. You draw forms more as you feel them than as you see them. Add some more details in the foreground. Create these tensions and play with your colors. Make these experiments and you will enjoy painting landscapes. Add a little bit of light color in the sky. If the sky is flat, it should be activated through lines, shapes, and brush strokes. Similarly, in the foreground also, by lifting some color, a beautiful effect can be achieved. Now a viewer can go inside of the landscape. The hand that holds the brush jabs forward, moves this way or that, the wrist turns or twists, the whole arm swings the brush across paper or canvas in a sweeping stroke. All these are the painter's gestures. You can soften some colors by working on the hand edges. You can create another cloud in the upper area of the sky by adding more light colors. Give some more highlights in the middle of the painting. You can use white color for that to enhance the perspective. Add more lines and more dark colors. I think observation is far more important than any scientific or academic training in perspective. Though this may be not apply to every individual, keep in mind the main lines, like this is the horizon line. But remember, you should know why to put this dark strokes. How much dark? How much light? This is very important. We have to add different ingredients, but how much? That needs a lot of practice. Most important thing is, don't be afraid of using colors. Has become chalky, then you can use direct color on it, just as I have used yellow ochre color. as oil color has more flexibility, so use it to its maximum advantage. It looks beautiful. If the painting needs any change, figure out what it is you want to do. Mix the exact color. Get the correct amount of paint on your brush and then hit the canvas, doing it in one stroke if possible. Revisions and additions should not look different or more studied than the rest of paint surfaces, but should be handled in the same spirit. If there are certain colors which are creating little tension, mix them up. Too much detail sometimes create problem, so remove those details. Soften them and reduce the intensity of color. In this way, you can achieve the desired effect. Oil colors need a lot of practice. The more you dark, the more easily you will be able to blend instantly what you feel. The emerging shape creates interest. The center part of the painting is our lightest area. I want to put light in this area because at the horizon the colors are very light. Follow your impulses, working quickly, so you won't have time to get bogged down in stiffly rendered description.